my man. Today on Readers Reviews, I review Aquaman, directed by James Wan in the sixth installment in the DCEU. So the movie takes place a bit after Justice League and Arthur Curry is still, like, patrolling the seven seas. In the midst of him doing so, Mira comes back into his life, letting him know that his half-brother Orm is about to wage war with the land. The only way of stopping Orm from gathering his army to become Ocean Master in order to declare war is for Arthur to overthrow him and take his rightful place as King of Atlantis. And the best possible way of doing that is to find a mythical trident that was once held by one of the greatest kings of Atlantis once upon a time. So then Arthur and Mira go on this adventure to find the trident and overthrow Orm before he becomes the Ocean Master. And readers, I will let you know this right now. This movie was fun. Give or take a couple of things that were a bit cringeworthy, but the majority of the rest of it was great. And honestly, while I should have expected it as soon as I found out that he was going to have more of a hands-on approach with the writing regarding certain DCEU movies, I was very surprised at how much of Geoff Johns' New 52 stuff was incorporated into this movie. I'm talking about the legendary trident, I'm talking about the trench, especially the trench, Jesus Christ. But given how many resources they pulled from different eras of comics of Aquaman, this story pretty much flowed nicely from beginning to end. There was also a very nice nod to Batman Begins as far as like how Aquaman's origin story was explained to the audience. No, seriously, the use of flashbacks in this movie was very well handled in my opinion. So with that being said, let's talk about the characters that stood out to me the most, starting with Arthur Curry slash Aquaman. Given the Aquaman that we were introduced to in Justice League, this was a proper next step in his development as far as everything that happened to him in this movie. And I think that they pulled it off pretty nicely, specifically Jason Momoa. And while it didn't necessarily affect the level of badassness that we know that Arthur Curry has, at least in the comics, plus whatever charisma and everything Jason Momoa gives to the character, the combination of the two plus the progression that he makes to become the Aquaman that we all know and love in the comics as far as King Aquaman or King Arthur Curry was very nice to watch. He realizes that he has flaws, he realizes that he needs other people, he realizes that he needs to become better and has obligations given what he is. Though while even at the end of his character progression in this movie, it still shows that he's more dumb brute like Thor was in Thor Ragnarok, you can still see that there's potential for growth to become the Aquaman that we know in the comics. Mira was awesome, she was just awesome. And while I do admit there were times where I felt that she only existed just to help Arthur advance or progress, she was still very much her own character from time to time. What helps in that regard is the conflict that both Mira and Arthur have in regards to what she thinks about land dwellers and what he thinks about Atlantis or Atlanteans. They both bring up very interesting facts regarding both sets of people that causes both of them to think about their preconceived prejudices about each other. And personally, I think that was a nice touch considering all the changes that they made to Aquaman in this movie while still staying faithful to the comics. And speaking of which, I love the physical changes that they made to Ocean Master. Specifically that they gave Ocean Master Arthur's original blonde hair and blue eyes. Because given what he does in this movie and given how he is in the comics, the physical changes made to Orm, in my opinion, perfectly reflect the bigotry and racism that's currently being reflected in our world, both now and in the past. Other things I really enjoyed about this movie was just like the set design, the costume design, the makeup, and the prosthetic design. They were all just beautiful. Even the way characters look when they're underwater was just like, wow, this is actually really good. This is really good. But outside of that, the only thing I can really nitpick about this movie is that there are moments where like Arthur came off as like dumb brutish, which I get, I understand. And there were a few jokes over the course of this movie where while they fit, they were slightly cringeworthy. But outside of that, I loved Aquaman. I really enjoyed it. I love that the story was coherent from beginning to end, that they pulled from multiple sources, including the New 52 stories. And outside of one reference to Justice League in order to establish as being part of the DCEU, you can pretty much watch this as its own thing. Whereas I'd understand if you want to catch a matinee for this, given the previous DCEU movies in the past, I would say that it's on par with Wonder Woman, and it's definitely worth seeing in theaters. So with that being said, readers, your homework assignment for the day. Write in the comment section below what you thought of Aquaman if you've seen it. If you want to help support the channel, you can purchase official merchandise by clicking the card at the end of the video or in the link in the description down below. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications because I post new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and every other Friday. But until then, this is Redis 101. Class dismissed.